I can share these. So I'm reading Aramaic, okay?
Okay.
But I'm reading a Zohar portion, Pinchas, verse 807. בעשור לחודש השביעי, דיו תשרי, it's called, talking about Yom Kippur, דיו תשרי, מקרא קודש יהיה לכם. די יום הכיפורים, דיו עשירי, יוד, כליל מעשר ימי תשובה, ותקינו בהי צלותין לחברה עם ה. המים מקרא קודש להפרשה למשאר יומין. דאית בהו פולחנה דחול בגין דק כל מלאכת עבודה, לא תעשו. Now please read the translation.
Sure.
Yes. You can
And you
see it?
shall and you shall have on no, make it the same. No, I can't see, is not the whole
Okay.
yeah, this is good. And you shall have on the 10th day of the seventh month, on this seventh month, which is the month of Tishrei, a holy gathering, Bamidbar 29:7, which is Yom Kippur, which is the 10th, which is Yud. And these are the 10 days of repentance, and five prayer services were ordained for it, in order to join the Yud with the He, oh my God, namely Chochmah with Binah. What is the meaning of holy gathering? It is to differentiate it from other days when the secular work is permitted, which is why scripture says you shall not do any work.
We'll jump 808 and we'll just go straight to 809. Please go ahead.
Okay, those over whom there is a verdict not to be changed under a vow or oath, or it was decreed. For this reason that the following shall be recited, all vows are made called nidre, bonds, they shall all of them be released and annulled. They shall not be binding, nor shall they have any power. But the verdict shall be voided from them. And this is why the vow is the name of Yud Ke Vav Ke, which is Tiferet, while the oath is in the name of Ad Hashem, which is Malchut, for they caused their own exile by their sins. And now, by means of Chokmah and Binah, they will be released and or annulled. They shall not be binding, nor shall they have any power. And all the congregation of children of Israel shall be forgiven. By Bar 15:26, Chesed is water, Gevurah is fire, and Tiferet is air. And since the vows are in Tiferet, which is air, the sages of the Mishnah therefore taught release from vows hovers in the air, for the release from the Chokmah and Binah hovers in the air, which is Tiferet, and from there annuls the vow.
So on Yom Kippur evening, we say Kol Nidrei, which basically we're saying all the vows that we're basically canceling them, right?
Mm-hmm.
What's the idea? That what is a vow means what it's if there is a decree, if God forbid, there's something that's still blocking my soul. I want to cancel it. Because what God wants to do on Yom Kippur, to give from the level called Binah, which is the endless love of God, to fill my soul with the endless love of God. So if there is a place inside that needs some light, I fill it with light. I charge myself with the light of love. If I didn't charge myself on Yom Kippur and I stay with my emptiness, that's how I'm starting my year. My frustration, I'm frustrated about life, I'm frustrating, God forbid, about my life, about God, about my wife, about my husband, about anyone, you know. So if I walk in life with deep frustration, so how can I share with anyone? And
That's
if
right.
I fill myself with the love of God on Yom Kippur, I allow the love of God to enter and to fill myself, so I can feel God is good, God is here, everything is good. I'm surrounded. Bina is like mother. It's like a child that feels that his mother is protecting him, covering him and hovering him. And when you feel that God always there, always loves you, never leave you, and even in the most painful thing in your life, it's also he was there for you and he's there for you. And those things actually are your greatest opportunities to jump and to grow, right? Once you realize that on Yom Kippur, when you open yourself, and that's how you start here. So you start with energy of sharing, with love, because you are so filled with the love of God. All what you want is just to share the love of God with everyone else. But if there's a decree, if I didn't cancel the vows, means if I didn't clean myself from all the from all this energy that's blocking me, and I still live with my fears and with my worries and with my bitterness, if I still live with that, so the light of Bina cannot enter, and I cannot charge myself with the light of God. So that's why, as we enter Yom Kippur, we say Kol Nidre, means all the vows, all the blockages that may be still blocking my soul, I'm canceling it right now. And as we cancel them, our soul is open and free, and I can be charged totally with the endless love of God. Okay?
Amen, yes.
Yes, and let's just do one last one. Okay?
I hope it's not too long because I have to go.
Okay, so you know what? Next time.
Yeah, Israel. Yeah, it has been a long time, Moshe.